Hey community, I just want to wish you a happy 65th anniversary. How cool is that? We're here at Balloon Fiesta in Albuquerque, New Mexico. We've been here for 13 years. It seems like just yesterday I was a student pastor at community. We still love you guys, appreciate your support.
Hi CCC, thank you very much because you support the work in Panama. And happy 65th anniversary. We are happy for you because we are part of you. Thank you because you send people here in the mission team to stay with us. Thank you for all you do for us. God bless everybody.
Congratulations, Community Christian Church, on your 65th anniversary. We look forward to many more years with you here in our wonderful city and partnering with you to help everybody in the community. Thank you again for all that you do. Looking forward to great years ahead. 2023 will be bright, and we're all very blessed that you are with us. And again, happy 65th anniversary.
Hey, Community Christian Church, love you guys. Thankful for you. 65 years of ministry. Oh my gosh, so cool. I am so thankful for all your church has done for us at Four Kids, and also what you're doing for our entire community. I'm blessed to know you guys. I'm thankful for you. Keep pushing forward. Don't give up. Love you guys.
All right. Hey, good morning. Welcome to community. Happy anniversary, everybody. Thanks so much for being with us. We're so excited to celebrate with you and so excited to worship together. And as we watch that video and we see those men and women on screen, the different partners that we partner with, not just here in this community, but around the world, to know that God is using community to do a great work and to spread the gospel, the message and hope of Jesus Christ all across this planet. So it's such an exciting thing. It's so cool to be a part of. And we're just thankful that you're a part of that as well. All right, so we're on our feet now. We're going to put our hands together this morning. We're going to sing with joy and excitement and give praise and glory and honor to our great God today. Here we go. Together like this, church. Come on. There's joy in this house. Come on.
We worship the
Come on, let's lift a shout of praise today. Come on, let's lift a shout of praise. Yeah. God. Just your voices. To be a part of this group who is serving the church and serving God faithfully. And with young kids coming up, I'm excited for the next generation. I'm gonna continue that work. I'm gonna continue the work, letting people know about the hope of Jesus in their life. But here's the thing, as long as we have breath in our lungs, God has a plan and a purpose for our life. We're on a mission. We're on a mission for more and more and more people to hear about and know and come into a saving relationship with Jesus. And so we're gonna sing this song, one more song together. It's just a reminder that if we're not dead, then God is not done. All right, He is still working, and that is our testimony. Grace and forgiveness and mercy is our testimony today. seat.
Hey, Community Christian Church, happy 65 years. I just wanted to reach out and say thank you so much for the time you put into my life. You not only challenged me to put Jesus at the center of everything I do, but you also challenged me to go into full-time ministry. And 10 years later, I've been in vocational ministry, and I attribute so much of who I am as a dad, who I am as a husband, who I am as a leader to my time at Community.
Hey, 3C, happy 65th anniversary. And I just want to say thank you for being a church home for me in middle school and high school. It allowed me to explore ministry and leadership while I was a student. Thank you for sending me into vocational ministry, and happy 65th anniversary.
Hey, community, I just want to wish you an incredible and happy 65th anniversary. That is absolutely amazing. There are so many people I would love to thank, from the volunteers to the incredible staff at Community. You have done so much in my life to bring me to where I am now.
Hello, Community Christian, and congratulations on your 65th anniversary. I'm very grateful for the role that Community played in my life when I was young. I came to Community in 1995, and that's where I became a Christian and answered God's call to go into ministry. Thank you to everyone who poured love and wisdom into my life.
Happy anniversary, Community. You know, growing up, watching and experiencing the life-changing power of the gospel is what led me to want to do it for the rest of my life in full-time ministry. Community is a very special place that I am grateful to have been a part of. Thank you so much, and congratulations on 65 years.
Community Christian Church, happy 65th anniversary. Thank you guys for showing me what true community is like and showing me examples of what a Christ-centered difference maker can do in this world.
Amen, amen. So good. Every single one of those young men in that video were part of the Community Kids, Community Students programs, graduated and made a decision not only to follow Jesus in their personal lives, but to follow him with their entire rest of their lives, all working full-time vocational ministry. And what an amazing opportunity for all of us to hear the legacy that you guys are making as you continue to invite and impact people's lives. So welcome, everybody, to Community Christian Church 65-year anniversary. So good to share that with you today. Hey, so good. Thanks for joining us online. Thanks for joining us here in person. We want to invite you, if you're here in person, that Connect card, seat back right in front of you. Every single person, you're always welcome to fill that out. Let us know your information. But on the bottom of that, we love those prayer requests. Fill that out. You can drop that in any of the giving boxes, all the lobbies, on your way out today. And if you're a first-time guest, thank you for coming to choose Community Christian Church, place to worship today on your way out. You take that Connect card, go out to our Connecting Point booth on the right-hand side as you exit. We got a special gift for you. If you're watching online, text this number. First-time guests. All right, we'll get that gift out to you in the mail. Thanks for making Community, again, a place to worship together today as we try to believe, belong, and become the people Jesus intends for us to be. One of the things we love, favorite seasons of the year, Christmas. Come on. Christmas, anybody? You excited? There we go. Christmas at Community, super special time. We've got four services coming up on Christmas Eve and Christmas Day, Saturday night, Sunday. We want you to come to them, of course, but we need your help volunteering, maybe holding some doors, greeting out in the parking lot, maybe holding a little baby so somebody else can come in and worship. Need some volunteers on those. So come to a service, volunteer at a service, and of course, invite some friends to join you for our Christmas at Community celebrations. Communion is an opportunity we have every single week to remember Jesus. We celebrate him coming to the earth during our Christmas time. But communion every week is a time for us to remember his sacrifice on the cross for us as we take the bread, which represents his body that was broken, the juice, which represents his life, the blood that he shed on the cross. It's a chance for us to repent and to praise and to give him thanks for what he did on the cross. So we invite you, after I pray, to enjoy some time remembering Jesus. Let's pray together. We love you, God, and thank you for today. Thank you for the opportunity we have to remember you And God, we thank you for the cross, the victory that took place on the cross to bring us back to you, the price Jesus paid. God, hear our prayers now as we thank you for those, as we repent of anything we need to. We give all glory and honor to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
One of the things we love to say around here is that we exist to change the world, one person at a time. And God has been doing that over these last 65 years. And then the last 15 years since we've been in this building, over 3,300 men, women, and children were baptized into Christ. And that is something to celebrate, yes. God's been using us, working through us, to reach our community and make a difference, but he's also been working through us to change the world. Listen to some of our missionary partners that serve all throughout the world.
Hi, Community Christian Church.
Community, happy 65th anniversary. We are so thankful for you guys. Thank you for partnering in the work that we're doing here in Valor in West Africa. And we thank you for the lives that you're impacting through your generosity and support of us and our team.
Congratulations, Community Christian Church, on your 65th anniversary.
We at Medindia are thankful to you for your love of prayers and generosity and enabling us to work in India for many years. Because of you, we are able to plant churches, take care of children of persecuted families, and evangelize our people with the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Hello to our friends and partners at Community Christian Church in Fort Lauderdale. We wanted to wish you a happy 65th anniversary and say thanks for the partnership and support you've been giving to Team Expansion Works and workers all over the planet. A lot of people talk about changing the world. You guys are actually doing it. May God bless you today and always.
Well, you saw Doug Lucas, the president of Team Expansion. You saw the Bowers family, the Law family. The Bowers are Team Expansion missionaries that are serving in West Africa. And we've been supporting just a lot of missionaries, but just the missionaries through Team Expansion that we support, this year in 2022, there's been over 2,500 people accept Jesus Christ and be baptized. That's tremendous. God is using you. God is using our generosity to make a difference, not only here in our community, but around the world. And it's just been exciting to be a part of. Well, this December, we are going to have a special Christmas offering focus. And as we just celebrate the indescribable gift of God's Son, Jesus Christ, we're also going to give back to God an over and above offering this season. And what this is, I just want to encourage you to be generous this December and to consider this Christmas offering. It's an over and above offering, and that just means it's over and above our regular giving. And I'm praying that some of you, this may be your largest gift this year. We're so excited about 2023. We're going to be launching the campus at Pompano Beach and so many other things. God's going to do a tremendous work, and it's going to be through you and your generosity that God's going to work. So thank you for what you do. If you came prepared to give today, you can drop off your offering in any one of the lobbies in the giving boxes. Or if you prefer to give online, simply go to communitycc.com/give, and you'll see all the ways that you can give online. Thank you, guys, for your generosity. Let's pray. Father, thank you. Thank you for how you provide for us. Thank you for all that you've done for us. But also thank you for doing things through us, allowing us to partner with our finances, our generosity. And you take that and you do so many more things. You multiply it more than we can ever imagine. And we're just thrilled to partner with you and be a part of what you're doing here in Tamarack and around this area in our community, but also around the world. Thank you for allowing us to be a part of that. We ask all this in Christ's name. Amen.
At 3 p.m. on Sunday, April 14, 1957, a service of dedication was held at this building on 31st Avenue in Fort Lauderdale, and Community Christian Church was born. Our pastors taught from God's Word, people came to know Jesus as Savior, and God blessed our church.
Fast forward to Sunday, June 5th, 1983, the date of the dedication service for this building in Plantation Acres. After buying this land and selling our first building, we were so excited to be in our new home.
The church grew, and in January 1994, Scott Einan was called to be our pastor. We added more staff, the church continued to grow, and we knew God had something much bigger in store for community.
Fast forward to Sunday, December 16th, 2007, the grand opening service for this building. Thousands gathered in this room that day as we welcomed Community Christian Church into its new home here in Tamarack. What an amazing celebration it was, and God has continued to pour out his blessings on our church.
In July 2019, we held a groundbreaking ceremony for the expansion of our Tamarack campus. On December 20th, 2020, we had the grand opening celebration for our recently completed next-gen building and the renovated auditorium. The new next-gen building will provide a great environment as we reach the next generation of Community Christian Church.
At the end of the year, 2020, we were given the campus of the former First Christian Church of Pompano Beach to be our first multi-site campus. And I was hired in 2022 to be the campus pastor for our Pompano Beach campus, which is currently under renovation and will have its grand opening in early 2023.
As we celebrate our 65th anniversary as a church and the 15th anniversary since our relocation to Tamarack, we have so much to celebrate. Our weekly attendance in 2007 was 925. Our current weekly in-person and online attendance is over 4,000. Community continues to make a difference in the local community through our community impact events and partner organizations and food distributions. Most importantly, over the past 15 years, over 3,200 men, women, and children have been baptized into Jesus in one of our baptistries or in the ocean a few miles from here. How amazing is that? And that doesn't count the thousands of people baptized by our missions partners like Team Expansion all around the planet. What an amazing ride it's been over these past 15 years in this location and 65 years total. And I believe the best is yet to come.
Bow at his feet, he has done great things.
Yeah. Such a great video. Thank you, Bill Kelly. Thank you, Brian Beckner, for putting that together. How are you guys doing today? Yeah, such a good day. Such a good day. So glad that you're here. Happy anniversary. Yeah, we're so glad that you guys are here and a part of this. And anniversaries are special because they allow us to, you know, to look back and also to look forward. And God calls us to do that. He calls us to do that in our spiritual journey, in our walk with Him. Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 9 says, "Be very careful never to forget what you have seen the Lord do for you. Do not let these things escape from your mind as long as you live. And be sure to pass them on to your children and to your grandchildren. The Lord your God will soon bring you into the land. Be careful not to forget the Lord who rescued you." And there are many of us in this room that God just, He just rescued us. He just did. And then He brought us as a church to this land a little over 15 years ago. We bought this land and then we moved in. It's 15-year anniversary for being in this building, December of 2007. 65 years as a church. And whereas the history of community begins in 1957, 65 years ago, the story of community actually goes back almost 2,000 years to the very first church that was born, the first church that began in the city of Jerusalem. And our leaders and our founders, they dreamed about creating a church that would emulate and that would restore that church in the New Testament. There's a very significant scene that happened when Jesus was on planet Earth. It's in Matthew chapter 16. He's walking with his disciples. His disciples had not declared that he is the Messiah yet. And Jesus took his disciples to a region called Caesarea Philippi. I mean, I remember the first time I went there 5 years ago, and I was at Caesarea Philippi just in October. We had 53 of us from community went to Israel. And it's not like it's a great picture that I took, but Caesarea Philippi, it's just so far north. I would not be surprised if most of the disciples had never been there in their life. It wasn't like it was on the beaten path. It was a multi-day walk that Jesus took them to. And it was this Roman province, Caesarea and Philippi. And it was just a multiplicity of gods, Greek gods and Roman gods. There's all these deities that were there. And it was in that backdrop that Jesus asked the question in Matthew 16, 15. He said, "Who do you say that I am?" You see all these other gods, all these other options. Who do you say that I am? You've been traveling with me. What conclusion have you come to? And Simon Peter in verse 16 answered and said, "You are the Christ. You are the Son of the living God." And Jesus said, "Peter, you're right, but you got it because God revealed that to you." And then verse 18, "And on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not overcome it." And Jesus was saying, "I am the Christ. I am the Messiah. I am the foundation of the church. I am the rock that you need to build the church on." And this small group of people in 1957, they determined that they were going to build a church on the rock solid foundation of Jesus Christ. And we've been continuing in that legacy ever since. And Dr. Perry Cook was the founding minister of community. And he saw a need for a non-denominational church in West Fort Lauderdale. Now, it was West Fort Lauderdale then. It's way, way, way out east for us now, being out west. And you saw the picture of the church and the small group of people that started Community Christian Church in 1957. They started with less than 25 members. They were small. They were under-resourced. But they had a great big faith and a great big God. David Chapman served as the senior minister from 1975 to 1978, and God used David in a great way. The church was growing. They having multiple services in that small church, and the church, if it was going to continue to grow and reach more and more people, had to relocate. So David Chapman led community in its first relocation. And so in 1976, this smaller group of people, they made a big decision. It was a big step of faith. They bought bought 10 acres of land in Plantation Acres, which back then, and it was in 1976 when they bought that land, the acres, Plantation Acres, everything west of University was pretty much dirt roads. And the acres were especially dirt roads and horse farms and orange groves and a little bit of swamp mixed in. And people were thinking, what in the world are you thinking? It's never going to grow that far west. I mean, there's no way that's going to ever happen. And they paid $175,000 for the 10 acres of land, $17,500 per acre. How foolish could they be? It was such a great decision. And David led them. And David's a friend of mine. He's become a mentor to me. He's an older minister now. He sends his greetings and his congratulations. And I guess he's going to be watching this video. So community, let's give a big hand for David Chapman. Thank you, David. Thank you, David, for leading in the first relocation of community. So in 1983, Community Christian moved into the Acres. And in 1993, 10 years later, Community took another huge step of faith, and they hired a 32-year-old youth pastor who had never been a senior pastor before. He's a Florida native, went to Florida Christian College, but that was about it. And that was me. And they hired me in 1993 and the fall. It was 29 years ago that they hired us. And we came, and here's a photo of our family from January 1994 that goes way, way back. And Chris was 7 years old, and Stephen was, he was 4 years old, and Lori was there. And and beautiful as ever, as you see her there, and some of you are looking at me and go, what happened to Scott over 29 years? Thousands of bowls of ice cream is what happened to me. I'm not going to lie about that, and frankly, I'm okay with that. So anyway, and God said in the book of Genesis, chapter 1, verse 22, he said, be fruitful and multiply. And those two little boys, they took that command seriously, so they got married, and now we've gone from a family of 4 to 12, and so there's Danielle, who's married to Stephen, and Alex is married to Chris, and we got 6 grandkids, and just God is so good, and life is good. And the cool thing about that photo for us is the first time the cousins ever met, because Steve and Danny, they live in Phoenix, and it's so expensive for them to fly to the east, you know, to Florida or wherever, and Chris and Alex, they live in Charlotte, so they met this summer. It was so awesome that way. A couple of stories that I want to highlight about the faithfulness of God. The first one is a personal one, because I was a student pastor. That's why I love our student ministry. And by the way, we have like one of the most incredible student ministries I have ever seen, with Alex and Mikey and Jonathan, and Jaylee's been, you know, it's her last day. And so we have such a great student ministry. And I love those guys. And they're doing far better than I ever did as a youth pastor. But I was a student pastor in Clearwater. And when I came here, I was excited, but I was actually a little bit apprehensive about one thing: doing a funeral. As a student pastor with students growing up, I was a student pastor for 13 years. I'd done a number of weddings along the way. They grew up, they went to college, they met somebody, they came back, hey, would you do our wedding? Sure. But because we were a larger church, had a multiple staff, I never did a funeral. So I still remember, before we came, I just prayed, God, please, if you could work it out that nobody dies right away, you know, in this church, and maybe like the first year would be awesome, you know. And that was my prayer. It was my prayer. And I'm not going to lie, God answered that prayer. My first funeral was 1 year and 1 day after I started. I didn't have any funerals in the first 12 months. In the 13th month, three people I had funerals for. And I've always kind of felt bad about that first guy. You know, what if I would have asked for 2 years? He may have, you know, lived a little longer. I don't know. But he was a godly man, a believer. He said, Scott, I'm good. I got to heaven when I wanted to. So anyway, but just like my predecessors at Community Christian Church, I tried to build on the Christ-centered foundation that was here before I arrived. And we came to Community, we tried to continue on the mission of Community. And our mission is to lead people into a growing relationship with Jesus Christ. So wherever you're at on your spiritual journey, we want to help you to take the next step and the next step. And there's longtime seasoned followers of Jesus that are part of Community. Some people that are, wow, it's the first time they've ever been in a church in their life. And wherever you're at, we want to help you to take the next step. Our vision is to change the world one life at a time. Let's say that together. Our vision is to change the world one life at a time. It's a big vision, but it's one life, one life, one life, one life at a time. That's what our vision is. This is a great story. It was the fall of 1997, and our leaders, three of us, John Chase and Mike Gearhart and myself, we were meeting and we're talking about our future. I'd been there for about 3 years and community was growing and growing and growing, and we talked about maybe we should buy some more land. Because what happened is when community moved into the building in 1983, well, all the payments started coming due around 1988, and community almost went under in the late 80s. And God stepped in and rescued community, and that's a whole other chapter of our story, but he did. And then after that, Tim Wallingford came and did a great job of growing community, and I followed Tim, and he set community up so well for us to continue to grow, and we're growing. But we sold during that time when community almost went under. The leaders sold off 6.5 of those 10 acres in order to survive. So it went from 10 acres down to 3.5 acres. And we were growing, we were adding services, and there's no way we could add any more buildings on that piece of property. And so we said, maybe we need to buy some of that land back. And so we met and we prayed, and maybe, God, is this what you want us to do, or to plant another church? Well, we had a meeting one night, and the next day, when I was driving into church, exactly what happened is there was a for sale sign on the piece of property that we had prayed about the night before that wasn't there the day before, because I passed that piece of property every single day, back and forth to work. That was a literal sign from God. It was awesome. And I got on the phone and I called John Chase. John, you won't believe what I just saw. So we bought that property and another one between the fall of 97 and the fall of 98. And we had 12 acres of land. Now the problem was, it was all zoned residential. And so we were in the acres and we need to rezone that so we could use it as a church. And we've been told that it was gonna be a little challenge, and we understood that. And it was more than a little challenge. It was a battle is what it was. And it was the forces that were, you know, trying to, you know, to say, we don't want you in our backyard. And it was in the acres, and they didn't want a big church. And I get that, and I understand that. But I mean, we felt that we were called by God to do this. And we felt that he had led us to buy this land. And so what happened was, is that by the time the decision came from the city council, the city of Plantation, it was August of the year 2000. It was the city council meeting that had more people attend than any other one in Plantation's history up to that point. There was 300 or 400 people that were there, spilling out into, you know, the hallways, and there were news channels there, and it was like a big deal. And after all the testimony, it's around 1 a.m., the city council voted no to honor our request to rezone that land. And we were deflated, because we've been striving for that. But here's the thing. We knew that there's not a city council on the planet that can thwart the will of God. I mean, that can't happen. And the truth of the matter is, it wasn't the city council of Plantation that said no. It was God who said no. God said no to that so he could say yes to this. That's exactly what happened. Wait a minute, Scott, I have a question. You said that God led you to buy the land, that it was a sign. Yeah, we did. We bought the land between 97 and 98 for about $50,000 an acre. When we sold the land a few years later, around 2003, 2004, some of the land had gone up in value 4 to 5 times in its value, and then we sold it. And so it was God took us to that place so we could have the resources to buy this space. So I want you to hear me. I love Max Lucado's quote. When God says yes, it is because he loves us. When God says no, it is because he loves us. And you can trust an unknown future to a known God. And God was in all of that. And the key for us personally, or as a church, is just trusting that God knows what he's doing, that God has this. And we did. And then we started to imagine. When we were shut down, we said, does God want us to try to fight this and try to shove this, you know, go through the courts and try to shove this down the throat of the people that don't want us in the area? Or is he calling us to find a new place, another relocation? And so we started a journey, and I wish I could tell you it was like, you know, a couple months. It was a couple years, and we'd start and stop. And then finally, this piece of property that was here, it wasn't even for sale. Somebody told us about that, and somebody knew somebody who knew somebody, and we made an offer, and we bought this land, and we were imagining the possibilities. And for those of you that have been around long enough, you know that we went through Cannonball, which is a generosity initiative, also known as a capital campaign. But back in the day, our generosity initiative was called Imagine the Possibilities. And we just imagined, and it was built on one of my favorite verses of scripture from the Apostle Paul, Ephesians chapter 3, verse 20. It reads, "With God's power working in us, God can do much, much more than anything we can ask or imagine." Isn't that a great verse of scripture? Let's read that out loud together. With God's power working in us, God can do much, much more than anything we can ask or imagine. And so as a church, we began to pray, and we began to sacrifice, and we began to give, and we began to try to follow the lead of God, and we began to imagine the possibilities. And if it wasn't for the people who were with us in plantation, I mean, it's always God, and he's the faithful one, but he works through people. He works through us. And so it's the people that he worked through in plantation that I am forever indebted to and grateful to, and I love the plantation people, and it was the plantation people that sacrificed and gave, and because of them, we're here. And so that's why I'm going to ask all the plantation people, if you were with us when we were in plantation, would you go ahead and stand right now? And the rest of the community family, you need to appreciate these. So plantation people, I know some of you are here, so please go ahead and stand up. So yes, thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. And it was our goal when we moved into this building 15 years ago that we wanted to be a place to believe, belong, and become. And that's been our slogan for the last 15 years. And slogans are important because they define an organization. And having the right slogan, though, for an organization is really important. For example, "Good to the Last Drop" is a great slogan for the Maxwell House coffee people. But "Good to the Last Drop" would not be so good, say, for the Miami Elevator Company. Just, it wouldn't be a good one for them. They could do better than that. They just really could. They could. And so the slogan of a place to believe and belong and become has become a good one for us. So I just want to quickly remind you about why we exist and what we're striving to do. We want to be a place to believe. Most of people on the planet, they recognize the fact that they have this spiritual longing, that there's a sense that there's got to be something more, that there's got to be something more than just this life. And it's a spiritual homing signal that God's placed in every one of us. Every single one of us has a God-shaped hole in our heart that can only be filled by God himself. And the Bible tells us in Ecclesiastes 3 that he has planted eternity in the human heart. And that's why we have this God-shaped hole. And we believe that we fill that hole in our heart by discovering the God of the Bible. And so that's why we are a Bible church. Psalm 119 verse 105 says, "Your word is a lamp to my feet. It's a light for my path." And we're a Bible church. They're a place to believe. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16 says, "All scripture, it's inspired by God. It's useful to teach us what is true and to make us realize what is wrong in our lives. It straightens us out and it teaches us to do what is right." So we believe that the Bible is not out of date or antiquated. It is relevant. The Bible compares itself to a mirror where we see ourselves. And if you read the Bible in a translation that's, you know, modern and understandable, you're going to see yourself when you read the Word of God. You just will. But I want to let you know, and I say this hopefully frequently enough so that you'll hear this, this is not just a place for the already convinced. If you have questions, if you're uncertain, if you have doubts, well, this is the church for you. And Jude 1:22 says that we are to be merciful to those who doubt. And so if you struggle, then I just want you to know that this is a church that we're gonna try to answer your questions. We're gonna try to walk with you through that because we feel this mandate from God, and one of, it's my life verse, and this bears out in what our purpose is as a church. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 15, "See to it that no one misses the grace of God." Let's say that together. "See to it that no one misses the grace of God." That is our heartbeat as a church. We don't want anyone to miss the grace of God. And we just celebrated. Bill mentioned it was on the video, but I'm gonna mention it too because it's the most important statistic of all that we have. During the last 15 years, 3,307 people have been baptized into Jesus Christ. Isn't that awesome? And that graphic is already out of date. It's 3,308 with Sabrina being baptized in the service. Isn't that awesome? Let's celebrate that. And community, if you were one of the 3,307 and you are baptized either here in this baptistry or in the courtyard or at the beach or even in the Jordan River, we just came back and 25 people were baptized in Israel in the Jordan River. If you're one of those people or even going back to plantation, if you made that spiritual decision to be baptized in Jesus, would you just stand? We just want to see that. We want to celebrate your decisions now. We just want to say way to go in that. Just, we're so excited about those decisions that so many of you guys have made. It's so awesome. It is so, so, so very awesome. So we're a Bible church. We're a place to believe, but we're also a place to belong. We all have a longing for belonging. We were made to do life together. We weren't made to do life solo. It says in the book of Genesis that God put Adam in the Garden of Eden, and it was this perfect existence, this perfect environment, and yet God said that it was not good that the man was alone. We're made to be in relationships with other people, in community, in life-giving relationships. Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verse 12 says, a person standing alone can be attacked and defeated, but two can stand back to back and conquer. Three are even better, for a triple braided cord is not easily broken. And we all need somebody to lean on. We all need somebody in our life that we can do life with. And as a church, one of our mantras, one of our goals is our vision is to help everyone who believes here to feel like they belong here. Those aren't just words. We want you to have this sense of belonging, this sense of connectedness, because it's transformational. It really is. And so let me just invite you to take a step. If you feel like this is a place that you believe, but you're not really sure that you belong, then we have all kinds of opportunities. We have rooted groups that you're gonna be able to sign up for in January, and you'll be with a group of people for 10 weeks, and you'll grow deeper, but you'll also grow in relationship with other people. And then people will become a part of a life group, and they'll get to know, and they'll do life together. And maybe it's not through a small group or a life group or a rooted group. It's by volunteering and being on a serving team. But that's how you're gonna have this sense of connectedness, this sense of belonging, that this isn't just the church that you attend. This is the family that you're a part of. Friends, in the New Testament, there are these passages called the one another passages. 94 of them. Pray for one another, love one another, serve one another, encourage one another. All the one another passages. And here's the thing. You cannot obey the one another passages of Jesus in isolation. You can't like do life. You can't be a Lone Ranger Christian. You can't do life on your own. You can't obey those commands. And so I love to say this. You can't reach your full spiritual potential in isolation because it has to be in the context of one another, and community matters. This is a place to belong. Community is a place where everybody's welcome. Nobody's perfect, and anything's possible. Why? Because God is at work here, and we're seeing him work, and it's been amazing for us to be a part of this. So community is a place to believe, a place to belong, and we are a place to become. I think all of us in our better moments, we want to become more than we are right now, become God's best version of ourselves. I know this, that God has a dream for everyone that far surpasses the dream that we have for ourselves. God has this desire for you to become more than you are. 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 18 says, but to continue to grow in the grace and the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Now, I want you to notice that indicates it's a process. Continue to grow. It's not instantaneous. It just doesn't happen right away. And we live in this culture where we want to microwave everything. And that's why I think a lot of people give up on spiritual growth, because they don't understand it's a process. It's a journey. It's not instantaneous. And so we just continue to grow. George Eliot, I quote, one of my favorite quotes, it's kind of like doing my favorite quotes, some of my greatest hits as far as lines that I like. It's never too late to be who you might have been. I mean, if you've been around community more than 5 minutes, you've probably heard that. I mean, I quote that all the time because I love it. It's never too late to be who you might have been. Yesterday, I was in my office, and I was going over the message, and I got up, and I walked in the family room kitchen area to get something to eat or drink, and my wife, Lori, was in there, and she was kind of tearing up, and she was watching ESPN football, which makes me tear up because I love the fact that she loves football more than I do. So anyway, not making this up. She's watching this, and it was one of these special segments that ESPN did a few weeks ago, and it was this most amazing segment ever, especially for an old guy like me. There's a guy, the segment was called Everybody Loves Ray, and it was about Ray Rochelle. He's a 49-year-old college freshman who went out for the football team at North Dakota State School of Science, and he made the team. So there's this 49-year-old guy playing college football, trying to make it, and I'm going, how inspiring is that? So I'm enrolling in college, and in the fall, that ship sailed a long time ago. You know, I'm sitting on my couch, and that's inspiring as I sit on my couch and do nothing. So anyway, but it's never too late to be who you might have been. I think inside every one of us, we have a desire. We don't want to just take up space. I don't want to just take up space. I want the world to be different. I want to be a difference maker, not a space taker. And God put that inside of us. And at Community, we're a place to become more than we are. And we believe that our actions, as our church, speak way louder than our words. And we are, friends, we are an externally focused church. It is not our desire to be the best church in the community. It never has been. But it is our desire. It's our dream. It's our goal to be the best church for the community. We want to be this church that's for the community around us, externally focused, partnership, community impact events. And that's what we're striving to do. And that's who we will continue to be. That's a part of our DNA. Community is committed to live by faith, to be known by love, and to be a voice of hope. That's what we want to be to those who are around us here in South Florida. And I know that is the heart of so many of you. And I just want you to hear this. God is so pleased with that heart when you want to be a part of that journey. Now, raise your hand on this. Do you know someone in your life, somebody that you care about, that you know they haven't accepted Jesus as their Savior and Lord yet? They don't have the hope of heaven. Does anybody have somebody like that? Yeah, a lot of hands going up. That's why we're not done yet. That's why we built the Next Gen building, so we could have more seats there so that people could come, so we could help more and more people find and follow Jesus, so that we could help more and more people not miss the grace of God. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 15. That's what we're striving for. We are. And we're just getting started. And that's why I'm so excited that in 2023, in the first few months, we're gonna relaunch the Pompano Beach campus. And what we're gonna do is this church just wonderfully gave us their property with a hope that there can be hundreds of people coming to faith, and we're partnering with them, and we're stewarding that gift that they gave to us, and we're renovating that building. And here's the thing, there's some of you who are in this building right here, right now, that you need to pray about whether God is calling you to be a part of the launch team for the Pompano Beach campus. What does that mean? That you make a commitment that you're going to be a part of the team for at least the first 6 months, that you're going to go and you're going to serve and you're going to volunteer and you're going to be a part of that. Because we need hundreds of people from community to go. Now, we need a lot of you to stay. So I just want to be clear on that, okay? So pray about it. And we want most of you to stay, but some of you to be a part of this launch team. We're just going to see what God does. And I can't wait till we start seeing just so many people come into faith in that part of our county as God works through us. And it's going to be all of us. And that's why 2023, I'm kind of landing back on a verse of scripture that was directed for us as the church, Ephesians 3:20, with God's power working in us, God can do much, much more than anything we can ask or imagine. And we're asking and we're imagining and we're just getting started. And we're going to see God at work. And I can't wait to see what's going to happen next year. It's going to be our best year ever. I really believe that. I do. It's the great privilege that I have to work side by side with some of the greatest staff on the planet. We have an amazing team. People from other churches around the state, they go, wow, how did you like amass like the all-star team at Community? I said, we just have so many great leaders that are on our team here. And so as a part of our anniversary celebration, I'm gonna have them come out in just a moment. I'm gonna have our elders and their spouses come out in just a moment. But before I do, I'm gonna ask my wife, Lori, if she will come on out. And we celebrate our 40th wedding anniversary this summer. So she's coming out right now. She's been so much a part of the community story for the last 29 years. And I gotta tell you, being a pastor is challenging. Being a pastor's wife, it's doubly challenging. It's one of the hardest roles on the planet. I'm convinced of that. And she deserves a medal for her role. And so, community, again, would you just express your gratitude for her? And what you may not know is that Lori writes my messages for me each week. She does. She's the, you know, and at least the good ones, the ones that are kind of flat or a dud, you know, that's, she's out of town and those are on me. So anyway, but anyway, we're going to go ahead and have the elders and their wives come out right now, their spouses. So if our elders would go ahead and come on out, and this is John Chase, our chairman of the elders, and his wife, Pat. John's been a part of community for longer than me. This is Sydney Martin. Jeffrey and Michelle Horst are coming out, and Dave and Murdy Murray are just walking around the building somewhere. We don't know where they are, but they were here in the first service if you want to see them. So, community, these are your leaders. They are the shepherds of this church. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We're going to ask now for our staff to come out, and for those that are able to make it for the service and their spouses, you guys go ahead and come on out. I think you're coming this way. So come on out and just stand in line here, be a part of this. This is awesome. Make sure you're not behind anybody. Some of you guys head on down to the other end. That'd be great. I get to work with these people every week, and I know their hearts, and I want to let you know they care deeply about you. They pray for you. They're for you. And they lead through challenging times. And the truth of the matter is, the season of COVID was the most difficult time for leaders to lead than any other time in my 41 years now of ministry. And they led through that. And they led through that so remarkably well. And here our church is. We've come out of COVID, and we're stronger than we were before COVID. And it's amazing. It really is. And so, community, would you express your gratitude and your thanks to your staff and to your leader? Yeah, let's do that. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you. The Apostle Paul had a special relationship with a church in Philippi. It's the most personal letter that he wrote. And he wrote to his friends in Philippi. He wrote these words, Philippians chapter 1, verses 3 and following. He said, I thank my God every time I remember you. In all my prayers for all of you, I always pray with joy because of your partnership in the gospel from the first day until now. And we have a partnership together as a leadership team of all of us, but that partnership is with you, all of us. It's the community family that we have this partnership in the gospel. And then I love how Eugene Peterson paraphrases this in The Message in chapter 1, verse 6. He says, there's never been the slightest doubt in my mind that the God who started this great work in you 65 years ago, that's my paraphrase, 65 years ago, would keep at it and bring it to a flourishing finish on the very day Christ Jesus appears. And so God is in this, and he's at work, and he's bringing this together and culminating in all that we're doing. And I believe that the greatest days of our church are ahead of us. And the best is yet to come, and it's going to be more than anything we can ask or even imagine. We're going to see God at work. And would you just pray with me as we celebrate the faithfulness of God together? Heavenly Father, we thank you for the way that you've been at work in our history these last 65 years. And I just touched on a few of the moments of your faithfulness. There are so many. God, we're thankful that we get to be a part of this journey and see you at work. Work in and through us. Father, we thank you for this building, but it's not a building that has saved us. It is a bloodstained cross and an empty tomb that has saved us. It is a Savior. It is Emmanuel. It is you with us. It is the Prince of Peace who has saved us. So, Father, it's my prayer that we would continue on this Christ-centered foundation, and that you would be honored and lives would be changed and that differences would be made and more people would be in heaven one day as a result of what we all do in this partnership and the gospel together. And Father, we pray all this in Jesus' name and for his sake. Amen. Amen. I'm going to ask if you'd just go ahead and stand, and we're going to sing a final song together. We're so glad that you're here today.
Anniversary t-shirt on your way in. We have them in all the lobbies. Now here's the deal. We have one shirt per adult that's here. This is not a free last second shopping spree for Christmas where you're loading them up on the way out. All right, so one shirt per adult, per person on the way out. Make sure you grab those. Also, hey, we have cupcakes in the courtyard to celebrate our anniversary. Excited about that. And of course, if you need to step towards Jesus' kingdom right here down front, we would love to pray with you this morning. If you're watching online, text the word prayer to this number, and we will be in touch. Thanks for coming to worship and celebrate today. Happy anniversary, Community Christian Church. We'll see you soon.